بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين، وبعد. Respected brothers and distinguished sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Firstly, indeed, we are all shocked and saddened at what happened last night whilst we were in the masjid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala offering the Salat al-Taraweeh, standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I'm referring to the callous attacks in London. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for the victims and the family of those that were affected. Just yesterday I was on the radio in the afternoon, and I shared a hadith which I would like to share relevant to what occurred last night. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu is the narrator of the hadith. He says that whenever the month of Ramadan would commence, he speaks about the practice of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he says, whenever the month of Ramadan would commence, أطلق كل أسير وأعطى كل سائل. There were two things that were known in the life of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the practice of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whenever the month of Ramadan commenced. Generally, what happens? How do we prepare for the month of Ramadan? You know, we do our grocery shops the week before, we're really, you know, fighting for time. Whenever the month of Ramadan commenced, look at the preparation of the Messenger for the month of Ramadan. Number one, أَطْلَقَ كُلَّ أَسِيرٍ. There was no prisoner in Medina during the month of Ramadan. Any prisoner in the prison of the Messenger in Medina, when it was the first of Ramadan, the Messenger released every single inmate, every single prisoner, regardless of the crime. Could have been a heinous crime committed, one offense against the Messenger, against Islam, you know, creating mayhem in Medina. But regardless, because it's the month of Ramadan, the month of sheer mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and a manifestation of this mercy by the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, was he released every single prisoner, let alone causing harm to someone, let alone, you know, killing innocent individuals. Here the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam would free and emancipate and liberate the prisoners from Medina. And then he goes ahead and he says, وَأَعْطَى كُلَّ سَائِلٍ. Any individual that came to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the month of Ramadan got whatever he or she wants. He gave everything in the month of Ramadan. Anyone asked for anything, there was only yes on the tongue of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam during the month of Ramadan. If the reports are correct, these individuals were shouting, this is for Allah, and this is for the sake of Allah. This has nothing to do with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It has nothing to do with the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a perversion of the message of Allah and of the teachings of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Anyway, the verses that we'll be discussing today, these speak about charity. Also Surah Al-Baqarah, towards the end of Surah Al-Baqarah, a significant portion of Surah Al-Baqarah is dedicated towards encouraging the believers to be charitable. Okay, helping out in humanitarian causes, being philanthropists. A significant portion of Surah Al-Baqarah, from ayah number 260 to ayah number 274. 15 verses of the Quran, which are about three or four sides of the Quran, dedicated just to infaq. Infaq fi sabilillah. Spending and being charitable for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the cause and in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah gives an example about charity. And then Allah speaks about how we should give charity. What should be the intention? What shouldn't be the intention when giving charity? How do you give charity? How shouldn't you give charity? When you give charity, what do you do after the charity? When you give charity, what shouldn't you do after you give the charity? Who do you give the charity to? Generally, you give it to needy individuals, but Allah highlights a particular category of beneficiaries, a particular recipients of charity, who you should look out, search for these individuals to give them your charity. Then Allah speaks about, okay, if you don't have any charity to give, what do you do in that circumstance, in that state? At what times of the day should you give charity? And so on. So there's a lengthy discussion about charity, as I said, from ayah number 260 to ayah number 274. Let's briefly go through some of these verses and what does Allah say about being charitable and giving charity. This entire discussion that we will be speaking about just now has nothing to do with the obligatory charity, the zakah. This is to do with sadaqah nafila, the voluntary charity. So zakah, Allah speaks about that at the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah. الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ. So, you know, Allah speaks about this already multiple times. He's already spoken about this, about the obligatory charity. This is the voluntary, Okay, the supererogatory charity, the sadaqah, sadaqah nafila that we call. Anyway, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins the discussion by giving an example. He says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم مثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله كمثل حبة أنبتت سبع سنابل في كل سنبلة مئة حبة والله يضاعف لمن يشاء والله واسع عليم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the example of those who give charity is like that of a single grain of corn. Okay, have you seen the corn? You know, they say, the corn, right? One small, how tiny, how insignificant is a seed, a corn, okay, a grain of corn. Allah says the example is like a grain of corn. You take that one grain of corn, كَمَثَلِ حَبَّةٍ, one grain. Okay, when that grain is planted, أَنْبَتَتْ سَبْعَ سَنَابِلِ, it bears, it produces 7 ears of corns, 7 full ears of corns. Not one. One grain doesn't produce one ear of corn. Allah says it produces 7 different, سَبْعَ سَنَابِلِ, 7 different ears of corn, the entire ear of corn, you know, with the leaves and those strings and so on inside. 7 different ears of corn. And each one, فِي كُلِّ سُنْبُلَةٍ مِئَةُ حَبَّةٍ, each one of those 7 ears of corns bear 100 seeds. So can you see just that one seed fetches you so much? Okay, fetches you so much of reward. Allah then says, وَاللَّهُ يُضَاعِفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. This is just an example. This is just a parable. This is just an analogy. Nothing could explain the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing could explain the generosity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You give 1 penny, 1 cent, you know, 1 morsel of food in charity, وَاللَّهُ يُضَاعِفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah will double, treble, Allah will increase it according to how much He wants to do it. There is no count. There is no maximum. Okay, there is no decrease in the treasures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاللَّهُ يُضَاعِفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَاللَّهُ وَاسِعٌ عَلِيمٌ. Allah gives as much as He wants. وَاسِعٌ, He is all-encompassing. عَلِيمٌ, and Allah is all-aware, Allah is all-knowing, you know, with the intention and why do we give. So Allah commences this discussion by giving this beautiful example that whenever you give anything in charity, Allah does not look at the quality, Allah does not look at the quantity, how much you're giving. In fact, what Allah looks at is the quality, the thought, the intention behind you giving. Why do you give? What's the reason for giving? Okay, the sympathy that we have when we're giving, you know, the very urge that we have for helping the other human beings, our fellow individuals, fellow human beings. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks at. Anyway, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, again, you know, this concept of Allah increasing the charity and increasing the reward and giving more when we give in charity and when we are charitable. Allah repeats this later on, as we shall see. Anyway, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Those individuals who give charity. Now, how should you give charity? What should be our approach when we give charity? الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ لَا يُتْبِعُونَ مَا أَنْفَقُوا مَنًّا وَلَا أَذَى لَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Allah says those individuals who spend and who are charitable for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the cause of Allah, ثُمَّ لَا يُتْبِعُونَ مَا أَنْفَقُوا, after they give, مَنًّا وَلَا أَذَى, they give and they walk away. They forget about what they gave. They do not. The charity that they give is not followed by 2 things. Man and other. Man is imposing your favor, reminding of your favor, reminding the person that you gave. Keep on, you know, reminding this person that I did this for you. Remember 5 years ago, 50 years ago, I did this for you. No. Allah says when you give, forget about it. Full stop. Okay, when Allah gives, He doesn't keep on reminding you that I gave you this, I'm giving you this. So why should we do this? Allah says, no. These individuals, when they give in charity, their charitable deeds are not followed by mannan, reminders of their benevolence, of their kindness, of their favor, of their mercy. And wala adhan, and they do not cause harm. Sometimes what happens is someone asks us for something, we give them, but we follow that, this is the last time, don't come back to me. How many times are you coming back? You know, find a job, you're so healthy. No. If you don't want to give, don't give. But if we're giving, our charity should not be followed by man, reminders of our favors, and other. No harmful words. Be kind. Don't. Okay, no harmful words. Allah says if we give this type of charity without man, without other, لَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. This is a pure charity. This will fetch all of the rewards that are promised by Allah and the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Lahum ajruhum 'inda rabbihim. For these people, their reward is by their Lord, by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wala khawfun 'alayhim wala hum yahzanun. Allah says there is no fear on these people in this world, wala hum yahzanun, and there is no grief for them in the hereafter. So Allah will sort them out. Allah will give them peace, comfort, serenity, contentment of the heart in this world. And more importantly, وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. They will not grieve in the hereafter. No grief for them. They will not be grieving in the hereafter. Okay. وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Then Allah says that this is, if you give charity, this is how we should give charity. Our charity should not be followed by reminding of our favors and by inconvenient and harmful and hurtful words. Then Allah says, if someone asks you for something, or if you see someone, there's a pledge, there's an appeal, people are asking for charity. Every day in the masjid there is appeal. It's fine. If you don't want to help, don't help. But don't criticize. Every single day in the masjid has nothing better to do, or the radio station has nothing better to do. There's always, no. Allah says, قَوْلٌ مَعْرُوفٌ وَمَغْفِرَةٌ خَيْرٌ مِّن صَدَقَةٍ يَتْبَعُهَا أَذَى وَاللَّهُ غَنِيٌّ حَلِيمٌ. Allah says, it is better for you to say a kind word, just saying something doesn't cost anything. May Allah help you. This is a brilliant cause. May Allah support you. May Allah bless you. Saying a good word, وَمَغْفِرَةٌ, and asking Allah to forgive you, and asking Allah to forgive the person that is asking. That doesn't take anything, it doesn't cost anything. Absolutely nothing. Just a few words. Allah says this is better than giving millions of pounds in charity, billions of pounds in charity. يَتْبَعُهَا أَذَى مَنَّن and وَأَذَى. After, you know, that million pounds of charity which is followed by a hurtful word. So you're giving as much as you can. You're giving a lot, but then after that, you know, it's followed by hurtful words. You know, do something with your life. You're wasting your time. Are you going to live off the charity and of the feelings of people? No. Allah says, it's better you don't give them anything, but say a kind word. And if you don't even have a kind word to share, don't say anything. Don't give anything, but don't even say anything. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. قَوْلٌ مَعْرُوفٌ وَمَغْفِرَةٌ خَيْرٌ مِّن صَدَقَةٍ يَتْبَعُهَا أَذَى. And thereafter Allah says, وَاللَّهُ غَنِيٌّ حَلِيمٌ. Allah is self-sufficient. Allah is independent. He does not need your charity. If you are going to give charity, after which you are going to remind people of your favors and you are going to harm them and be nasty and mean to them, Allah says He is غَنِيٌّ. Allah, He is غَنِي. He is independent. He is self-sufficient. He doesn't need your wealth, and even the poor person doesn't need your wealth. When we are giving charity, firstly, we need to understand that we are not doing others a favor. Those that we are helping, we are not doing them a favor. We are helping ourselves. Allah, we should thank each time we give charity, each time you give someone a pound, you drop a pound inside the masjid bucket, or whatever cause it is, thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, oh Allah, you have used me as a means for helping someone. Otherwise, if you wanted, you could have not used me. How many times there are appeals in the masjid and we don't give? How many times we don't give? That's because Allah doesn't need our wealth. That's the reason we're not giving. That's the reason. So the next time we give, it is because Allah has allowed us to give. Allah wants that wealth from us. No matter how insignificant it is, Allah says, no. Oh my servant, I want you to give because I need to bless you. It's fine, even if you drop 50p, but I want you to give something. So the next time we give charity, we are not doing the poor person a favor. We are not doing the individuals and the organizations a favor. We are doing ourselves a favor. It is for ourselves, and we are helping ourselves and our families and so on, as we shall see the various benefits of giving charity. So Allah says, قَوْلٌ مَعْرُوفٌ وَمَغْفِرَةٌ خَيْرٌ مِّن صَدَقَةٍ يَتْبَعُهَا أَذَى وَاللَّهُ غَنِيٌّ حَلِيمٌ. And then Allah says, this is a caution from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُبْطِلُوا صَدَقَاتِكُمْ بِالْمَنِّ وَالْأَذَى. When you are giving charity, it takes a lot of effort. You have a lot of bills to pay. It's not easy. You have children. You have family. You need to go on a holiday. You need to put food on the table. There's so much of expenses we all have. You need to pay for your Wi-Fi. You have car insurance. You have this. There's so much of bills we all have. But you're going out of your way. You're giving the charity. Then Allah says a word of caution. When you're giving the charity, لا تبطلوا صدقاتكم بالمن والأذى. Don't cancel that charity. Don't spoil that charity of yours. لا تبطلوا صدقاتكم بالمن والأذى. Again, don't spoil it by man and by other. Can you see how Allah is repeating this? Time and time again, Allah is saying, don't spoil. This spoils your charity. It fetches nothing. Okay, it fetches nothing. No matter how much we give, it's all zero in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we are going to remind the people and the individuals of the charity that we're giving them, and if whilst giving them or after giving them, we are going to be hurtful to them, we are going to be mean to them. Allah says this is spoiling the charity. It cancels out the charity. لَا تُبْطِلُوا صَدَقَاتِكُمْ بِالْمَنِّ وَالْأَذَىٰ كَالَّذِي. And then Allah again gives an example. He starts this concept of charity by an example, and then Allah gives an example of those individuals who give, after which they remind of their favors and their kindness, and then they say nasty and meanful words. Allah gives an example. كَالَّذِي يُنْفِقُ مَالَهُ رِئَاءَ النَّاسِ وَلَا يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ فَمَثَلُهُ كَمَثَلِ صَفْوَانٍ عَلَيْهِ تُرَابٌ فَأَصَابَهُ وَابِلٌ فَتَرَكَهُ صَلْدًا لَا يَقْدِرُونَ عَلَى شَيْءٍ مِمَّا كَسَبُوا وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الْكَافِرِينَ. Allah says those individuals who cancel their charity either by reminding of their favors and their kindness, or by hurtful and mean words, or by giving charity and thereafter bragging that this is how much I've done, this is what I've done, I've built a masjid here, I've sponsored so many orphans, I've, you know, the windows in this masjid, they all, you know, my name's on there. No. Allah says examples of individuals who give charity like this, كَالَّذِي يُنْفِقُ مَالَهُ رِئَاءَ النَّاسِ. Allah says, فَمَثَلُهُ كَمَثَلِ صَفْوَانِ. Look at the profound example Allah gives. Allah says their example is like a rock, right? You have a hard rock, flat surface, a hard rock with عَلَيْهِ تُرَابٌ, with some sand, just some sand on that rock, on that flat surface, just some sand on there. فَمَثَلُهُ كَمَثَلِ صَفْوَانٍ عَلَيْهِ تُرَابٌ فَأَصَابَهُ وَابِلٌ فَتَرَكَهُ صَلْدًا. So there's this rock, there's some sand on that rock, and then a heavy rain, torrential rain comes down, and what does the rain do? The rain wipes away and washes away the sand, and there's nothing there, it's just the rock. In other words, Allah says, it's like an individual, there's rock, there's some sand, and then you want to plant something, you dropped a few seeds in there. Obviously, that it's not going to be established. It needs to be deep in the ground. You know, rain will come and just wash that away, and it's the flat surface again. There's nothing there. Allah says that's the charity of these individuals. They're giving with so much of passion, but then after that, they're bragging. There's ostentation, there's favors, there's reminders, there's nasty words. Allah says one rain would come and it washes everything away. The charity is zilch, it's zero, there's nothing there. And then as we spoke about the balance in the Quran, when Allah speaks about good, He speaks about bad. When He speaks about punishment, He speaks about Jannah. So when He gave this example, then Allah gives the example of those individuals who spend with a pure good intention for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ومثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم ابتغاء مرضات الله وتثبيتا من أنفسهم كمثل جنة بربوة أصابها وابل فآتت أكلها ضعفين فإن لم يصبها وابل فطل والله بما تعملون بصير. Allah says the example of those individuals who spend for the cause of Allah, for the sake of Allah, pure good intention to help people, they give the charity and they forget they've given the charity. Okay, they give the charity and then they say to the person, listen brother, listen sister, if I could help you, you know, please let me know. There's my number here. Are you looking for a job? I have a friend who's looking for, you know, we help individuals. These types of people. وَمَثَلُ الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ ابْتِغَاءَ مَرْضَاتِ اللَّهِ وَتَثْبِيتًا مِّنْ أَنفُسِهِمْ. Their example is, كَمَثَلِ جَنَّةٍ بِرَبْوَةٍ أَصَابَهَا. Their example is like a garden, like an orchard, like a garden. Where is this located? Not on a rock. Allah says this orchard, كَمَثَلِ جَنَّةٍ, where is it located? On a hilltop, on the top of a mountain, on the peak of the summit of a mountain. كَمَثَلِ جَنَّةٍ بِرَبْوَةٍ أَصَابَهَا وَابِلٌ. The same torrential rain comes, but this time it doesn't destroy and wipe away the sand and the dirt, but this time it comes, فَأَصَابَهَا وَابِلٌ. Allah says that when this rain comes, كَمَثَلِ جَنَّةٍ بِرَبْوَةٍ أَصَابَهَا وَابِلٌ فَآتَتْ أُكُلَهَا ضِعْفَيْنِ. It comes and it supports, it helps this garden that instead of producing and yielding results once, in fact, it yields double the amount. It yields double the amount. It's nutritious, it's valuable, it's beneficial for this garden. That's the charity of those individuals who give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah says, okay, you don't always get heavy rain all the time. Allah says, fine. You don't even need, because these people have given with such a pure intention. فَإِن لَمْ يُصِبْهَا وَابِلٌ فَطَلْ. If there's no heavy rain, even the dew, you know, you have the mist and the dew at the top of the mountain. Allah says, even the dew is sufficient for the vegetation and for the plantation to grow. even the dew. So there's no rain, even the dew is sufficient. In other words, that, you know, there is reward and nothing but reward for these individuals. Okay, Allah will give them in this world and Allah will give them in the Akhirah. However, if Allah doesn't give them in this world, Allah will definitely give them in the Akhirah. The rain and the dew. Okay, فَأَصَابَهَا وَابِلْ and the فَطَلْ. Then Allah gives another example. This is an amazing example. Now this example is such, Allah tells you, I want you to imagine. Allah is allowing us, He's telling us, okay, each and every single one of you, the reader of the Quran, imagine this example. أَيَوَدُّ أَحَدُكُمْ أَن تَكُونَ لَهُ جَنَّةٌ مِّن نَخِيلٍ وَأَعْنَابٍ تَجْرِي مِّن تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ لَهُ فِيهَا مِّن كُلِّ الثَّمَرَاتِ وَأَصَابَهُ الْكِبَرُ وَلَهُ ذُرِّيَّةٌ ضُعَفَاءُ فَأَصَابَهَا إِعْصَارٌ فِيهِ نَارٌ فَاحْتَرَقَتْ. Allah says, أَيَوَدُّ أَحَدُكُمْ. Would each one of you like that you have أَن تَكُونَ لَهُ جَنَّةٌ, that you have an orchard, you have a farm, an orchard, a plantation, جَنَّةٌ, of what? مِن نَخِيلٍ وَأَعْنَابٍ, of palm date trees, and not just palm date trees, وَأَعْنَابٍ, and vines, تَجْرِي مِن تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ, with graced with streams flowing, fresh, you know, springs and streams flowing inside. Okay, look at this picture that Allah is drawing. Which one of you wouldn't wish this? Allah says, which one of you wouldn't like this? And then Allah says that thereafter, you know, you have so much. You have so much of wealth. This amazing plot and piece of land you have with palm trees and vines and grapes and, you know, streams inside. And then Allah says, وَأَصَابَهُ الْكِبَرُ وَلَهُ ذُرِّيَّةٌ ضُعَفَاءٌ. Thereafter you grow really old. You become so old that now you can't do anything. You can't look after this farm, this expensive property that you have. You can't do anything about it. You're really old. And then Allah says, وَلَهُ ذُرِّيَّةٌ ضُعَفَاءٌ. You have children, but your children are ضُعَفَاء. They are very young. They are infants. Huh? Allah says, you are old, and your children are extremely young, because generally what happens when you grow old? You count on your children. But Allah says, no, your children are very young. They are infants. وَأَصَابَهُ الْكِبَرُ وَلَهُ ذُرِّيَّةٌ ضُعَفَاءٌ. In this state now, Allah says, what happens? فَأَصَابَهَا إِعْصَارٌ فِيهِ نَارٌ فَاحْتَرَقَتْ. A fury, you know, wind comes, whirlwind comes, and it destroys the entire farm. Everything inside, it destroys everything. نَارٌ فَاحْتَرَقَتْ. And then there's a fire and everything is burnt down. How would you feel? You're leaving the world, you're really old, you have young, helpless children. You were counting on, you left all of these beautiful things for them, and now it's zero, everything is gone. Allah says, this is the example of those individuals who give charity, not those who don't give charity. Allah says, this is the example of those who give charity, but that charity is followed by what? Man, adha, and riya. Reminding of your favors, hurtful words, and bragging of the charity. That's the example Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives. Another way of understanding this example is that there are individuals that are in a similar circumstance. Imagine if you were in that circumstance. What would you want? You know, everything is gone. Your farm is gone. Your children are young. What would you want at that time now? You can't work. You're old. You're retired. You can't go back and start working. Your children are young. They can't work. What would you want now? The only thing you're counting at that time is on people around you to help you. So Allah says, likewise, there are people also who are going through a similar situation, if not worse, and they are counting on you, so you help them. They are counting on you, so you help them. And then Allah says, this is how we explain our verses and how we explain our ayat and so on. And then Allah mentions, Ya أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. What type of charity should we give? This is very, very important. Many of us give charity, but let's see, is this the type of charity that Allah wants us to give? Ya أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. أَنْفِقُوا مِنْ طَيِّبَاتِ مَا كَسَبْتُمْ وَمِمَّا أَخْرَجْنَا لَكُمْ مِنَ الْأَرْضِ. Allah says, give from the pure that we have given you. أَنْفِقُوا مِنْ طَيِّبَاتِ مَا كَسَبْتُمْ. Give from the pure that you have acquired and you have earned. So the money that you have earned, you went out, you sweated, you earned, Allah says, give from the pure portion of that wealth. Generally what happens? There's 2 days left over food, give it to the neighbor. No. If you want to give it at the time when you cook, before you eat. That's the time. أَنْفِقُوا مِنْ طَيِّبَاتِ مَا كَسَبْتُمْ. Your clothes have been really old, you wore the shirt, your son wore the shirt, your grandson wore the shirt, now let's drop it outside in the box, outside the masjid. No. Allah doesn't need that wealth of yours. أَنْفِقُوا مِنْ طَيِّبَاتِ مَا كَسَبْتُمْ. I remember an incident when we were little children. One of my teachers, he said to us that when my son got married, then, you know, someone gave us a gift. And when we opened the gift, it was an old shirt inside. So he says, I was so offended. So I, you know, kept the shirt away. And when that person's son grew up and he got married, I sent the same shirt back. Full stop. Okay. So Allah says, no. When you give charity, give that which you would like. And subhanAllah, look at what Allah says after that. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu anfiqu min tayyibati ma kasabtum wa mimma akhrajna lakum min al-ard. And then Allah says, وَلَا تَيَمَّمُوا الْخَبِيثَ مِنْهُ تُنْفِقُونَ وَلَسْتُمْ بِآخِذِيهِ إِلَّا أَن تُغْمِضُوا فِيهِ وَلَا تَيَمَّمُوا الْخَبِيثَ. First Allah says, give the pure, the good, that what you would want. And then Allah says, وَلَا تَيَمَّمُوا الْخَبِيثَ. Don't give the filthy. Allah calls that filthy, dirt, impure. That's what Allah calls it. And then Allah says, وَلَسْتُمْ بِ... If that same thing was given to you, if that same thing that you are giving, if that same thing was given to you, وَلَسْتُمْ بِآخِذِيهِ إِلَّا أَن تُغْمِضُوا فِيهِ. You would take it with your head turned and your eyes closed. That's how you would accept it. So insignificant, so trivial. When you accept that same thing, that's how. Look at the words Allah says. وَلَسْتُمْ بِآخِذِيهِ إِلَّا أَن تُغْمِضُوا فِيهِ. You don't even want to see it. You don't even want to see it. إِلَّا أَن تُغْمِضُوا فِيهِ. So Allah says, no. When we give, even if it's something small, but ensure it's something which is good. Okay, لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. Give that which you like, that which you cherish, that which you want. Anyway, thereafter Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الشيطان. When you give charity, each time you're about to give charity, there's a pledge, there's an appeal that's been made. You see these, disturbing images and pictures of, you know, orphans and women and children and men and so on in these circumstances, in these conditions. And then you make up your mind and you say, okay, I will spend. And as soon as you say that in your mind, okay, I will give something, instantly shaitan comes. And what does shaitan say to you? Oh, you have council tax to pay. Huh? You need to buy a gift for your wife. You don't usually buy any gift, but at that time when you make the intention, then you, oh no, I still need to buy something for my wife. Huh? I need to give my children school fees or tuition fees or whatever the case is. الشَّيْطَانُ يَعِدُكُمُ الْفَقْرَ وَيَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالْفَحْشَاءِ. Allah says, when you want to give in charity, at that time shaitan will come down and he will threaten you with the prospects of poverty. You're giving £1, but shaitan will threaten you with the prospects of poverty, that you'll become poor. Has anyone become poor with giving £1 or 50p? No. But at that time you'll start thinking about poverty. No, I need to save. I need to spend more wisely. All of these years I've been wasting money. Now I need to spend. That's why now I need to save. Allah says, no. That's from shaitan. Whenever you get the thought of spending, give instantly. Don't even wait to go home. Give instantly. الشَّيْطَانُ يَعِدُكُمُ الْفَقْرَ وَيَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالْفَحْشَاءِ. On the other hand, Allah says, that's the threat and the promise of shaitan. What's the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? وَاللَّهُ يَعِدُكُمْ مَغْفِرَةً مِّنْهُ وَفَضْلًا. Allah promises you forgiveness and Allah promises you abundance. So one side you have the promise of shaitan, on the other side we have the promise of Allah. Whose promise are we going to take? Whose promise are we going to take seriously? The promise of shaitan or the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he continues speaking about charity. And, I'll just end with the last verse that Allah speaks about charity. Allah says, لِلْفُقَرَاءِ الَّذِينَ أُحْصِرُوا. You know, in between Allah says, whatever charity you give, you will find it by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will increase your charity. Then Allah speaks about the types of people you should give your charity to. Okay, give those that are indigent, those that are poor, those that are needy, family members, and so on. That's important. But Allah says, go out and consciously look, seek this one category of people. الذين أحصروا في سبيل الله لا يستطيعون ضربا في الأرض يحسبهم الجاهل أغنياء من التعفف تعرفهم بسيماهم لا يسألون الناس إلحافا. Allah says, there's a particular group of individuals. They are poor, they are needy, they are in abject poverty, but you would not know. You would not know that they are needy. Why? يَحْسَبُهُمُ الْجَاهِلُ أَغْنِيَاءَ مِنَ التَّعَفُفِ. People, by looking at that, they would think these individuals are well off. They dress well. They speak in a good manner. Okay. They don't go out and beg. تَعَفُف. They're very independent. Okay. They would not go out and stretch their hands and ask people, listen, brother, can you do this for me? Listen, sister, can you do this for me? Allah says, no. Because, they don't want to ask people. Okay, they're relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are not complaining, they are not moaning, they are not groaning. They are happy with the condition and the circumstances they are in. Allah says, no, you look for these people. These are the types of people you should be giving. And then thereafter Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَةً فَلَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Those individuals who spend by day, those who spend by night, those who spend openly, okay, in public, and those who spend discreetly, secretly, in private. These are the types of charities we should be giving. Give charity at night, give charity during the day. Give charity when people know. So there's a pledge in the masjid or wherever it is. Stand up and say, listen, this is how much I give. It's okay. As long as your intention is pure. Why? You are giving it. And by you giving, you're encouraging people around you. Allah says, no, do that. That's fine. That's okay. إِن تُبْدُوا صَدَقَاتِ فَنِعِمَّاهِ وَإِن تُخْفُوهَا. So both, you know, give charity openly and also give charity secretly. In the hadith, the Messenger speaks about the seven categories of people who will be given the divine shade of the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. On that day when the Messenger says the sun will be exactly above the heads of people, people would be drowning in proportion, in their sweat in proportion to their sins. Some to their ankles, some to their knees, some would be drowning inside. May Allah protect us, may Allah save us. The Messenger says there would be seven individuals that would be given the divine shade of the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of these categories of those individuals, and look at the way the Messenger articulates this. He says, those people who spend with the right hand that even the left hand of that person doesn't know, let alone anyone else. You know, you've given with your right hand and even your left hand doesn't know. That's how secretly you've given. Let alone your wife knowing, your family knowing. Sometimes it's difficult to give anything without us telling our wives, huh? But Allah says, no, you know, 20p, 50p, it doesn't matter. Do it, inshallah. You won't get into trouble. Okay, you won't get into trouble. So giving the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let me end with one note. And that is what we started off with. Allah says, if you give in charity, يُضَاعِفُ لِمَن يَشَاءَ. Allah will increase your charity. Allah will increase your charity. You know, immediately, we'll discuss this tomorrow inshallah. Immediately after these verses of giving in charity, what do you think Allah speaks about immediately after this? Allah speaks about interest. And Allah speaks about usury. And there's a strong link and relationship between this, which we will speak about tomorrow. Allah says, when you give charity, you are physically seeing your wealth decreasing, right? You are seeing your wealth decreasing. And Allah says, when you take interest and usury, you are physically visualizing your wealth increasing. But Allah says, your eyes are deceiving you. Your eyes are deceiving you. When you give in charity, you're physically seeing your wealth decreasing. But Allah says, I am telling you, your wealth is increasing. And when you receive interest, Allah says, you are physically seeing your wealth increasing. But Allah says, I am telling you, your wealth is decreasing. The Messenger ﷺ in the hadith, when he expresses and he speaks about sadaqah and charity, the Messenger ﷺ says, As-sadaqatu burhanun. That charity is a proof. Burhan, right? Charity is a proof. The hadith scholars, they debate and they, you know, question and they, you know, why did the Messenger say charity is proof? Proof of what? So they say this is proof of one's iman. Okay, only a believer would give charity. But that's not true, because there are so many non-Muslims who are great philanthropists. You know, this foundation and that foundation, I'm not going to take anyone's name, but this foundation and that foundation and, you know, this and that. So even non-Muslims are giving charity. So proof of what iman are we talking about here? They say, yes, this is proof of iman. But what type of iman? This is proof that the individual knows that when I'm giving charity, my wealth is increasing, but Allah tells me it is increasing. And when I accept interest, my wealth is increasing, but Allah tells me it is decreasing. Despite this individual, the believer, the true mu'min is saying, oh Allah, I have iman in what you say. I will not accept what I am physically saying. I reject what my eye is telling me, but I accept what you are telling me. This is the essence of iman bil ghaib. That my own body, my own eyes can lie, but Allah will never lie. Allah will never lie. This is true iman. This is iman bil ghaib, believing in the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is believing in the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Obviously, when you're giving sadaqah, you give charity, I'm sure you all have your own story and your own tale. And I have mine as well. You know, you gave one day, you were walking, you saw someone, or there was a cause and you gave something and you forgot about it. And then 2 days after that, you went home or whatever it is and you found someone came. They knocked on your door and they gave you wealth. Let me give you an example, inshallah. I was in the town center. This happened here in Peterborough. And, you know, I was walking with my wife and I saw someone on this corner, and I didn't have anything with me at that time, and I really wanted to help this person. So I went back, it was really far, I went back to my car, and I came out from my car, and I went and gave him something. And I forgot about it, and I came back home. When I came home, I was looking for something else in one of my drawers, and I opened the drawer, and I found three clean, crisp 50-pound notes that I had left there and I forgot about it. I didn't know it was there. I completely forgot about it. And I was, subhanAllah, you know. So I'm sure, you know, it's summer now, you know, winter time, you're going to take your jackets out again, you put your hand inside and some money comes out. You know, you got some tax refund or, you know, you loaned someone some money and the person wasn't giving you back and you forgot about it, or you didn't expect the person to pay you. And then after a few years, something happened and the person pays you back. And so this is just in this dunya. That's not why we give. But that's, Allah says, no, we'll give you these opportunities and these instances and these circumstances. In the akhirah, you have your reward anyway. Wallahi, don't undermine. La tahqiranna minal ma'rufi shay'a. The Messenger says, don't undermine any little good that you can do. Even if it is 10p or 20p, help. Just help. Just help. And, you know, as I always say, sadaqah and helping is not only financially helping. Yes, that is financially helping. The Messenger says, kullu ma'rufin sadaqah. Every good that you do is sadaqah. Every good that you can do, any type of good, monetary or non-monetary, financial, not any type of good. And then he gives some examples. Wa taslimuka sadaqah. If you give someone salam, salamu alaykum, that is sadaqah. Just greeting, hello, hi, how are you doing? How was your day? That is sadaqah. The Messenger says, imatatuka al-adha anit tariq sadaqah. You're walking on the street, you saw a stone, a rock, or banana peel, or whatever it is, you moved it, you shift it on the side, that is sadaqah. The Messenger says, if you can't even do that, just smile. Ibtisamuka fi wajhi akhika sadaqa. Just smiling when you meet someone. Just having a smile on your face. Doesn't cost you anything. The Messenger says, that is sadaqa. Saying a good word, qawlun ma'roof, that is sadaqa. Yesterday I was going to the radio station, okay? And, you know, sometimes you say something good and you forget about it. You don't know. So I was going to the radio station. I just got off my car and I'm walking. And a brother from the other side of the street comes running towards me. Salaam alaikum, Shaykh. Salaam alaikum. So I greet the brother. I've never seen him before. He knows me. He asks me, do you know me? And it's embarrassing if I say no, but I said, listen, brother, I don't know you. So he says, it's okay. So I says to him, mashallah, you know, good to see you. How do you know me? You know, what's your name? So he says, few months ago, you visited one of the prisons in Peterborough. Huh? A few months ago, you visited one of the prisons in Peterborough and you were invited to speak. So you spoke and you mentioned a few things. And alhamdulillah, just a few weeks ago, I was released from prison. I even forgot I went there. Okay. And the brother says, I remember, you know, what you said. And inshallah, you know, I'm going to change my life from now onwards. And I'm going to be on the deen and this and that. So the point I'm making is, you know, you don't know. I don't even know who this brother was. I said something there and I walked away and I moved out. There were 200 prisoners there. And, you know, I went away. I carried on with my life. So any little good that we can do, wallahi, don't undermine any good, whether it's financially helping someone or even a good word, doing dua for someone. Listen, brother, I wish I could help you, but I don't have anything. I mean, need myself, but may Allah help you. May Allah make things easy for you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our charity and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the ability to look for opportunities to help people. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in wa akhir da'wan alhamdulillah rabbil alameen.